Good morning, children. Are you fine? Okay. Welcome to EBS online classes. Already we are in lesson 8. Shall we continue the lesson? Yes. Children, observe the pictures on page number 37. The first picture is Soni's family. The second picture is Rangaya's family. They are taking their food. Yes. Children, tell me what is the difference between these two pictures? Yes. In Soni's family, all are eating together. But in Rangaya's family, except mother, all are eating. Okay. Now, tell me which is the better way of eating. Yes, it is Soni's families. They are eating together. Children, do you know why should we eat together? Because it helps in sharing the food items equally among all the members, and we can have lots of fun, and also we can learn good eating habits from elders. Text reading, page number 73 and 74. Soni stays with her parents and brother. Shall we see how they take meals? In Rangaya's residence, their uncle also stays with them. Observe how they are taking their meals. You have observed the above two pictures. Now, say how the people are eating at Soni's house, how the people are eating in Rangaya's house. Which is the better way of eating and why? On what occasions does the family eat together? Why should we eat together? Relatives came to Soni's house for a festival. Meals were arranged for all at a time. Soni's father and brother served them. Look at the picture given below. Generally, all the people, including elders and children, sit together and eating during marriages, birthday parties, and festivals. This inculcates the value that all are one and equal. It is good for the family to sit and eat together every day and share their happiness of the day. I repeat, generally, all the people, including elders and children, sit together and eat during marriages, birthday parties, and festivals. This inculcates the value that all are one and equal. It is good for the family to sit and eat together every day and share their happiness of the day. Yes, all the people sit together and eat during marriages, birthday parties, and festivals. This inculcates the value that all are one and equal. Okay, children, let's move to the next topic. Can everybody eat everything? Children, observe the following picture. Yes, this is the picture of an infant. How this baby? How is this baby? So cute, no? Yes. What does the baby eat? Yes, infants don't have teeth. They can't chew the food. So they are given either milk or soft food. Look at these pictures. They are having teeth. Yes, they can eat everything because they are having teeth and they can chew food properly. Look at this picture. Yes, an old woman. This is a picture of an old woman. Yes, she cannot eat all food items because old people also don't have teeth. They can't chew the food and won't digest all the food items. Text reading, page number 74, last page. Mahesh brought roasted sweet corn while returning from home from school. He tried to feed it to his baby brother with it. His mother refused this as his brother was an infant and he could not eat it. Then he rushed to his grandfather to offer him the same. He also refused, saying he could not eat it. I repeat, Mahesh brought roasted sweet corn while returning home from school. He tried to feed it to his baby brother with it. His mother refused this as his brother was an infant and he could not eat it. Then he rushed to his grandfather to offer him the same. He also refused, saying he could not eat it. Why some food items cannot be eaten by infants and old people? Ask your elders and know what items do old people eat, what food items infants do eat. Fill in the table. First column is persons. Second column, food items they can eat. Next column, food items they cannot eat. Let us see infants. Infants can eat milk, soft food. They cannot eat rice, roti, curries, etc. Old people, they can eat fruits, dosa, idli, curd, and all soft food. They cannot eat chapati, chicken, mutton, etc. Others, they can eat all items. Children, we know that infants don't have teeth, so they can't chew the food. That is why they are given milk or soft food. Okay, old people also cannot chew food because they lose their teeth in old age, right? So they also eat soft food. In this way, food habits change according to the age. Good. Children, eating food is very important. In the same way, we should have good food habits like eat breakfast every day, eat more fruits and vegetables, drink more water, at least 8 to 10 glasses. Take food in regular intervals. Drink milk every day. Okay? We must wash our hands and legs with soap before eating. Okay, children? We should not spill the food on the floor. Yes, we should eat carefully without wasting food because food is very precious. Children, do you know there are many people who don't have anything to eat? When we are eating food 3 or more times a day, they are struggling to eat at least once in a day. Yes? So, never waste food. Text reading, page number 75. Infants don't have teeth. They can't chew the food. So, they are given either milk or soft food. People lose their teeth in old age. So, old people also cannot chew. They also eat soft food. In this way, food habits change according to age. Eating good food is very important. In the same way, we should have good food habits. We should wash our hands and legs with soap before eating. We should not spill the food on the floor and waste it. I repeat, infants don't have teeth. They can't chew the food. So they are given either milk or soft food. People lose their teeth in old age. So old people also cannot chew. They also eat soft food. In this way, food habits change according to age. Eating good food is very important. In the same way, we should have good food habits. We should wash our hands and legs with soap before eating. We should not spill the food on the floor and waste it. Okay, children, let's stop today. We will meet again in the next class. Take care. Bye. Have a blessed day. Thank you.